All right, welcome to chapter 7, section 2, called congruence. This is for math 8. So a couple things you'll see on your screen here. The first thing you should see is a due date. I don't see that on my teacher preview, but you'll see it on your student screen. Number attempts is always unlimited. So you can come in and try your assignments as many times as you would like, assignments, tests, and quizzes. Number of questions just tells you how many questions there are in this particular assignment. Grading policy is always best score. Whichever attempt is the best one is the one you keep. And partial credits enabled. In this case, you have to answer the one question to get credit for the one question. But normally we have more than one question where you would, you know, you could answer, you know, one of so many to get credit for however many answer correctly. Please remember, once you start your homework, you must finish it before you can work on anything else. So that means once I click start here, no matter what, I need to click what I see down here in the bottom right hand of the screen, which is submit assignment button. There's only one question here, so either you've done the one question or you haven't. So once you're ready to leave this screen, you click submit assignment. If you just close the screen or close your computer, it's going to lock you out of all your other assignments because Alex is going to assume you want to leave this attempt open. Remember, you have unlimited attempts. There's no reason to leave it open. If you have not clicked check, you don't have a green check mark, it's not going to save whatever you have typed in here. So make sure that you finish the problem for this one before you leave the screen so that it saves your progress and you click submit assignment. So it's going to stop it from locking you out. That's one of the big reasons we want to do this. The second reason is it's going to affect the grade book once we get in here and do this. Before you click submit assignment, your account's kind of like frozen a little bit. We can't see what you've been working on. So just make sure, click that button. On the side, we have explanation, example, and message center. So explanation literally tells us we're going to lose our question attempt because it's going to give us the answer to this question. So it's not going to give you the answer and then let you come type it in. Example will give you an example pretty much exactly like what we're looking at. The figures are a little different, but that's okay. It's still two triangles. And what we're doing here is we're matching up corresponding parts. So if you've never looked at corresponding figures before, what we're going to look for are the markings. So to mark angles, we use these little arcs. And we just match them 1 to 1, 2 to 2, 3 to 3. For the side lengths, we just use these little tick marks. So 1 tick mark, 1 tick mark, 2 tick marks, 2 tick marks, 3 tick marks, 3 tick marks. So it's, you know, very straightforward, I hope. We should not use just different colors and use, you know, one of each color. So I shouldn't see, you know, one arc, one arc, one arc, one arc, one arc like that with just different colors because there's a lot of issues with that. It could get copied in black and white and then we lose that kind of sequence. We don't really know what belongs to what. Or if someone's looking at this who maybe doesn't have the ability to see all the colors, like someone who's colorblind, something along those lines. We don't want to have issues where someone can't interpret it because of something gone wrong or something, you know, that inhibits them from seeing it. This lets everybody see very clearly 1 to 1, 2 to 2. So we're going to match up angles and side lengths using those marks, and then we're going to write a congruency statement for the triangle. We want to make sure that they're in what's called corresponding order. And what that means is once I know which angles corresponding or congruent to A, and so I go 1 to 1, so A goes to X, well, if A is the last one here, X should be the last thing listed in the second triangle. And we can see that when I scroll down here, X is the last thing listed. And if B and Z are congruent to each other, so they have the same number of arcs, then B is first, Z should be first. So it's literally lining them up in which angle is congruent to which angle. So if we read BCA, then I want to go ZYX. We can just read it just like that. All right. So now that we've gone through this example pretty, you know, closely, we're going to kind of finish this problem. The other thing you can do also, sorry, is message your teacher from the screen. So if you get stuck, we can come back and help you where you need to be helped. So let's go ahead and complete this problem here. So we're just going to match up the arcs. So A has two arcs, so I'm going to come over here and find two arcs, so that's Z. And I'm going to do this in capital letters because it's Alex can be very picky about that between capitals and lowercase. It has capitals here, so I'm going to leave them capitals in my answers. B has one arc, so I'm going to come over here and find one arc, that's X. And C has three arcs, so I'm going to come over here and find three arcs, which is Y. So now that I have these, I can also match up the side lengths. So if I have AB, here's AB, I want to go, here's three tick marks, I have three tick marks here. I'm very picky about the order on this one. Alex is not as picky. I think they should be in corresponding order here as well. So if it's AB, AB it should be ZX. I believe Alex will let you type in XZ. It's not as picky about that. But I think just for practice purposes, you should always match them up. A goes to Z, B goes to X. Just to get in that habit. AC, so AC is one mark. So I know it's going to be this guy here. I want to make sure I put it in order. So I went A to C. I'm kind of skipping over here. So I'm going to go Z and Y. Z to Y. Instead of YZ, I'm literally naming it ZY because it, A goes with Z, C goes with Y. All right, last one, we have BC. So BC has two tick marks. XY here has two tick marks. So let's make sure we have B to C, so X to Y. And now we're just going to do that same thing on the bottom here. So it goes A, C, B. So we're kind of going in a different order there. So I'm going from A to C to B. So I'm going to go from Z to Y to X. So Z, Y, X. So just very much so when you're doing this problem, pay attention to the order. The order matters quite a bit. If it's not in the right order, it will not be correct. So pay attention to the order you're typing these in. That is section 2. I will see you in section 3.